Good morning, students, and welcome back. I'm your science teacher here with the fourth video class of the chapter Keeping Safe. And today, in the continuation of the same chapter Keeping Safe, we are going to discuss today the safety rules which we should follow when we are on the road and the safety rules which we should follow when we are traveling in a vehicle. So starting with the first part of the video, that is safety rules which should be followed by us when we are on the road. So the very first rule is walk on the footpath. When students, when we come out from our house to reach our destination, we should always take the left side of the road, that is called footpath. And if there is no footpath on the road, we should always take the very left side of the road edge so that we can safely reach to our destination. According to the traffic rules, we, the pedestrian and also the person, those who are running with the vehicle or driving a vehicle, always take the left side to move. So it is very necessary for us to know the traffic rules to be safe on the road. The second point is that when we cross the road or the pedestrian cross the road, always use the zebra crossing. Zebra crossing is the pattern marked on the road which is specially made for the pedestrians. Do you know why it is called zebra crossing? It is very interesting, students. It is known as zebra crossing because it has the marking that there is in the zebra's skin. Isn't it interesting? Yes. That is why it is called zebra crossing. If you want to cross the roads, you can choose the other option such as subways. But never forget to check either side of the road when you are crossing the road. Then you move ahead. It is very important for us to check the road when we are crossing the road. First you look your right side, then left side, then right side. If there is no vehicle, you can move ahead and cross the road. The next is, do not ride the cycle on the busy road. I know that you, most of you, love to ride a bicycle, but students, never go on the busy road to ride a bicycle. You always choose of the places where there is no traffic or very less people are there. Then you go for a ride on your bicycle. And there also you always take your safety measures. That means you always wear the helmet, the knee pads or the elbow pads, so that you can make yourself safe if you fall down. Your safety is, you know, is in your own hand. So be careful. When you are riding a bicycle, you use your hand as a signal when you want to turn, to take a turn on the road, so that the people or the vehicle which is in the back side of you, they can easily understand that you are going to take the right turn or the left turn. So it is very necessary for you to follow these signals to give a message to the other person, those who are in the vehicle or those who are behind of you. Students, always follow the traffic signals. The three different lights gives us the three different instructions. The red says to be stopped, the green says to go, and the amber says to be ready. So you always remember the meaning of these three color traffic lights. So whenever you will be on the road, you just keep yourself, you can keep yourself safe from the accidents or any injury. Not only you should follow the traffic lights, you should always also follow the traffic policeman who is instructing the traffic rules for you. He actually helps us to clear the traffic, help the pedestrian to move, help the vehicles, the person, those who are running or traveling by a vehicle, to move ahead. So traffic policeman is also a helper for us, those who are helping us to be safe. Now the safety rules which we should follow while traveling in a vehicle. Students, we generally travel through a bus or through our private car or vehicle, that is motorbike, or by the train also we travel. So many public transports also we use to move away or to go one place to another place. So when we are using or traveling through these transports or these transportations, we should always keep some safety rules in our mind. The first is, when we are traveling by our own private car or private four-wheeler, we always use the seat belt when we are sitting in the front of the car. We should not play loud music in the car, as it can disturb the driver or the person who is driving the car. Either we are in the private vehicle or in the public transportation, we always encourage the driver to follow the traffic rules so that our journey can be safe. When we are traveling by a bus or any public transports, it is especially, I am telling for you, all of you students, because so many of you are availing the bus facility to reach the school or to reach home from the school. So it is very necessary to make you understand the traffic rules or the safety rules which you should follow while you are in a bus. You should never lean down from the window, or you should never take out your hand or head outside the window. It may be dangerous for you. So always keep yourself safe by sitting inside in the bus. You always follow the instructions given by the conductors or the helpers, those who are with you in the bus. You should not disturb by howling, shouting, or by chatting in the bus to the driver. The concentration of the driver should be on the road, on the traffic rules, so that he can follow the safety rules and he can safely reach you to your home. Never get up and move around inside the bus. So if the brakes suddenly apply, you will fall. So be safe when you are in the bus. So it is better for you to sit on your place. When you are departing from the bus or boarding to the bus, always be careful that you are in a queue. That means you are standing in a line, so that when you will board the bus or you will depart from the bus, you will be safe. Don't push anybody. Don't rush to get on the bus or to get off the bus. Have the patience and calmly, silently, or be disciplined when you are coming out or getting into the bus. And one most important rule that which you should tell your parents or elder ones, those who are driving the vehicle, that they never ever will use the cell phones, as it distracts their concentration, their attention from the driving. It may cause accident. So always instruct or always encourage your elder person or the driver or your parents that whenever they will drive the car or vehicle, they will never ever use or receive any phone calls. So those were the some safety rules which you should follow when you are on the road, or the safety rules when you should follow when you are traveling in a vehicle. So student, this is all about today's class. I hope that you will remember these points when you will come outside from your house and you will on the road, or you will be traveling in a vehicle. Stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you, students.